trouble road for half a mile.
Just wash his car. Come on, man.
What's up, guys? Mustang 2005 here, and today we're at Double Trouble State Park. And we're gonna check this place out. It's not that big of a park. I'm only here because it's part of another video I'm making at the moment, which is roadside places in New Jersey. And I'm here because there's a weird NJ article that says this is the Double Trouble mystery spot. And apparently, I don't actually believe this, but apparently, according to the article, a UFO landed here. So we're gonna go see the supposed area where it landed. That's the only reason I'm here, because I thought it sounded cool, and let's check it out. But, you know, it's a park, so there's other things to see. I'm not only going here for that. You know, I'm going to explore the trails itself. Very sandy. These are the Pine Barrens. Let's see what this says here. Double Trouble Village. So, unfortunately, everything is going wrong today, and it's really infuriating. Where should I start? I'm not even gonna bother. I'm not gonna bring this video down. But yeah, everything is just going wrong today. All right, so this is the village. And I'm trying not to fall in this sand. This is interesting. Whoa. Damn. Oh my God. I'm literally drifting here. See? Everything going wrong today. I hope the whole trail isn't like this. Oh, this is actually really cool. This is even better than LAR State Park. This looks like it's straight out of the West. Wow. Let's go see what that sign says over there. Oh. I didn't know it was gonna be sandy like this. It's also very windy today. Cranberry sorting and packing house. Oh, I guess they grew cranberries here. I'm stuck. Oh, I don't remember if I even mentioned it, but in case I didn't. So right now, this is being filmed on the brand new Hero 11. Now, I know I've been saying I don't want to upgrade, but the problems I've been having pretty much left me no choice. It basically forced me to upgrade, because I can't put up with all this glitching anymore. It's getting out of hand. I can't deal with it anymore. So I went and got the Hero 11, and I got it on, I got it like $110 off, because right now, it's like I said in the last video, in LAR State Park, GoPro's 20% off, plus I had a $10, yeah, let me go down there, even though it's sandy. I was gonna try to avoid it and walk down there. So I had a $10 card or whatever, gift certificate. So I saved $110, and that's pretty awesome. Right now I'm just shooting in my regular mode that I would use on the Hero 9. And speaking of the Hero 9, I know I'm doing all this blabbering while viewing, touring this place. Wow, this is really nice. But speaking of the Hero 9, ironically, just when I buy this, what happens? I'm getting in the car today to use my Hero 9 as a dash cam, you know, to record when I'm driving. It slips out of my hand and breaks the back screen. First time in history I've had every GoPro, not one has ever broken except this one. Only because it fell on the cement ground, obviously. But come on, man. But that's everything going wrong today, but it's a good thing I got this Hero 11, because now, I mean, the camera still works, it's just the whole back screen is smashed. Anyway, enough for my ranting, and let's check this place out. So, I guess this is where the cranberries were. Something's walking in there. Anyway, my rant is over, and I don't know where to go. Oh, and another problem. My Sony camera is almost dead. It's at 10%. I don't understand. I charged it. I can't win today. Everything's going wrong. All right. We'll continue in this village here. We'll go down this road. We'll go all the way down to where that supposed mystery spot is. And then there's some trails we can take. Did we see this sign already? I don't think we did. Oh, whoa! Oh, this gives you information about everything. Step back in time and explore the historic lumber and cranberry industries of New Jersey. Circa 1900. I would have thought older than that. Wow. Pretty cool, this place. I wonder why it's called Double Trouble. Oh, look at that. Is that an army gear? Oh, wow. I couldn't see because of my sunglasses. So hopefully this video comes out okay on the Hero 11. I'm using it for the very first time. And I know what settings I'm supposed to use, but I still don't know if it's dialed in because it's the first time using it. Maybe the settings I use on the Hero 9 might be a little different from on this camera. You know, I haven't troubleshooted or anything yet. This is straight out of the box with my own custom settings that I usually use on the Hero 9. And hopefully it comes out good. But, oh, that squirrel scared me. But I have confidence that these are the good settings because it's what most people recommend the settings to use, so I'm not worried. But this is really cool. I'm sorry for rambling this entire video. Oh, it's a walnut tree. Let me change some settings because this has 5K and 10-bit. Now, I did do a little test of 10-bit. My computer really can't handle the 10-bit, but I still want to make a small clip anyway. And I want to try out the new 8x7 aspect ratio mode. Okay, this is 5.3K and the 8.7 aspect ratio. I know it's a little technical. You probably don't know what any of that is. Also, I'm using... I forgot. So, also I'm shooting in the vibrant color mode. The last videos were in natural color mode. And all that means is difference in coloring. Now, from what I've seen in tests, there's very little difference between natural and vibrant, like what I'm using right now. It's a little bit more, I think, saturated. Vibrant, but we'll see how this looks. And this is also the 8x7 mode, but it looks like probably going to be using natural colors because it looks a little better. Double Trouble Sawmill. That whole, it's all missing, like, there's no opening. Oh wow, that's cool. Wow, this is a nice shot. Actually, let me change some settings again. Pretty much all testing. Okay, right now the only difference I made is the color profile. I changed it to flat, because apparently it's better in high dynamic range situations, but you have to color grade it. So we'll see how it looks. I'm probably not going to use this mode. Wow. This is interesting. All right, we'll see how this looks on flat. This is a high dynamic range situation, so we'll see how that works. And now there's two more things I want to test. We have hyper view, which is even wider view than super view. Let's try that, because right now I'm in wide view. All right, this is hyper view. I also went back to 4K, so I don't make so many videos in 5K, because it's very hard to edit. This is 4K 60 in Hyperview, and I'm using the auto boost feature, which is the stabilization. It basically automatically adjusts my stabilization. Now, where's that spot? Let me check really quick, because I feel like it's around here somewhere. Oh, we're up just about there. And then we'll go check out some of the trails. So this is 4K 60 in hyper view, but I'm not going to stay in this. I just want to test it out. All right, the only difference with this video now is linear mode, horizon lock, 360. Now, it's not going to be wide angle like I usually have it. This is a linear mode. Oh, this is a nice shot here. Ooh. But basically, let me show you a quick example. So right now the camera's level, and I'm gonna turn it all the way around, 360. We're upside down, and now we're right side up, and that should have stayed exactly the same. That's 360 lock. All right, the last thing I'm gonna test now, we're back to 8x7 mode, 4K 60, but now we're in 10-bit, also natural color profile. So basically what 10-bit is it allows a lot more colors to be recorded. This is the strangest looking water I've ever seen. We're in Pine Barren country, you know, Jersey Devil's around here somewhere. Maybe that's why it's called the mystery spot. It is a little mysterious. All right, so this is 10-bit. Again, it doesn't run well on my computer, so that's it for this. All right, we're back to our regularly scheduled programming. I know, that made no sense. I just wanted to say it. But we're back to my usual settings, except I'm using 4K 60. Normally I use 30 frames a second, but I want to see what 60 frames does for me. I'll get less battery life, and it's probably not even necessary, but all right, let's continue. Let's see what this sign says here. This looks like a really old bridge. But this is a beautiful view here. Wow.
Pretty cool.
So I couldn't exactly find where exactly this supposed UFO landed, but if I had to guess, based on looking at Google Maps, it looks like it would be this area coming up, because it looks kind of strange, and I guess that's the spot, because, I don't know, there's no way there was a UFO. Superstorm Sandy recovery. All right, let's go down here, check it out. So this is supposedly, according to Weird New Jersey, the Double Trouble mysterious spot where supposedly a UFO landed. I don't know how true that is, but it's interesting. I'm assuming this is the area, because it doesn't exactly say where it is, but this is the park, and this is the strangest looking area of the park. So I picked this as the spot, because, well, you can't really see it from here, but I don't know, there's a whole bunch of trees missing, and that's why I guess they call it the mysterious spot, because if you see here, all the trees are missing. And that's why they think supposedly the UFO landed. But that's very interesting. Alright, so that's it from here. Let's go check out the rest of the park. I'm gonna reuse the same clip I just made in this video for the other video. So if you watch both videos, you'll see the same clip from here. All right. Interesting. That is very interesting though, because why are all the trees like, it's just all stumps. Mysterious spot. It's like a big clearing. That's why it's called mystery spot. But let's finish this up. I started this very late, way later than I wanted to, because everything is going wrong today. It's already 5:30. Oh, we have plenty of time. I want to go to Barnegat Lighthouse after this. Never been there. That'll probably be, it's definitely gonna be a different video from this. But I want to check that out. But for now, let's see what this place is about. Oh, also I went back to 30 frames a second, so we're back in my normal settings. The only other difference now that I'm using, as I turn wind reduction off on the GoPro to see if it makes any difference, I don't think so, because I'm using the lav mic. And two, I'm using a custom white balance. I don't know how good it's gonna look. Supposedly, it's good for all general. Oh, we just missed a plane. I'm gonna go back to auto though. All right, so that was all shot today in a custom white balance. I don't know how if it's gonna look any good, but this is automatic. These are my default settings, and we'll stay with this from now on. And no more tech talk, because I did all my tests. Check this place out now. Since it's such a small park, let's just fly right through. And the sand is not that deep here. Now let's hope we don't run into the Jersey Devil. Wow, what the hell? It's a weird looking swamp. Oh, one more thing. The only other difference, besides my usual settings for the GoPro, is the auto boost. Just because it's, it's supposed to be a lot better. I might not need full stabilization in certain situations, and that's why it adjusts automatically. So that'll be a helpful feature. So that's one new setting that I'm using. But I don't think I really need to use any of the new settings, because I pretty much don't really need them. Unless I really need them, like, I'm never gonna really use 10-bit or 5.3K, because it's a huge file size and it makes it harder to edit. It's a very, very weird spot. I see why they call it mystery spot. Huh. All right, let's figure out where I'm going here. All right, let's go to the end. There's three strips of this, which makes me think this was a farm. This kind of looks like a farm. That would explain the three strips. It's a little cold in the shade. I would have done this a lot earlier in the day, but I had different plans originally. I was gonna do the Barnegat. I hope you can hear me with this wind. This is crazy. I was gonna do the Barnegat rail trail, but I was reading the reviews and people said it's not very scenic, and I had to wait for the battery of this to charge fully. Because that would be a 20-mile round trip. And if I had read the comments sooner, I would have left sooner, because I wouldn't have needed a full battery for this. So I screwed up. And like I said, all day problems. This is so weird. Huh. It's probably gonna be very similar scenery down this way. So let me go down the other strip. What I really should have done was come down this first and then, it doesn't matter. What's down that way? I mean, these are trails, they are marked, but I don't have the trail map around. I don't wanna get lost in the Pine Barrens. Maybe I'll find the Russian from Sopranos. What's down here? This is very odd. I guess that's the Pine Barrens for you. Wow. I'm pretty much just going by, I'm pretty much going by Google Maps. Oh, this is a way we can go. You know what? Let's go down that last one, loop around, and come back over here. Just so we can cover all the strips. Maybe we'll see some other strange stuff. Ooh. So, most of the Pine Barrens is all strange like this. Like, I would like to go to a Wharton State Park, I think it's called. It's in the direct smack middle of the Pine Barrens. But I don't want to go by myself because, like, it's literally in the middle of nowhere. So I would only do that if I was with someone, because that's too risky. But it's probably very similar to over here, based on what I've seen on Google Maps and stuff. And it's pretty creepy. Could you imagine being stuck here at night? Probably pitch black. Because we're pretty much by Barnegat, and it's like almost to the end of Jersey. Not really, but almost, like a little more than halfway. So it probably gets pitch black here at night, and you can probably see amazing stars. But I don't want to be stuck here at night. They do have camping in the Pine Barrens, but I don't know about that. It's like this goes on forever, huh? This is another trail. Where does that go? I don't think I want to go down there.
Factory Branch?
No, let's not go down there. Let's go back the other way. Alright, let's continue. This way we can get over to the lighthouse, finish this up, get over to the lighthouse before it gets too dark. It's getting colder. It was only 70 today. I don't know what's going on with the weather. It was just 80 and then it was freezing the last 2 days. It was in the 60s and it was just freezing. And right now it's probably 67. Yeah, let's hurry up and finish this up before it gets too cold. It's already almost 6. And it's gonna be an hour and a half to get home, and that's not counting any traffic. Oh, there's so much traffic just to get here. Because it's Friday, everyone's going down to the shore. I left at the worst time. That's my own fault. I have absolutely no idea where I'm going. I'm just following this. It is a nice trail. It's perfect for riding this. Oh, we're next to the highway. Well, that's good. I'm close to civilization. Because I didn't know where the hell I was. I'm basically in the middle of nowhere. I'm cold. Oh, shit. It's a good thing I wasn't going fast. Let me see where the hell I am. All right, good. It loops around. I don't want to have to go all the way back around. And then there's, you see the opposite side, that's all that's left. Stop which way? Let's go that way. That'll lead back to the car, but I don't want to go back to the car. The fact that this is like basically the middle of nowhere is probably why they thought they saw a UFO. I could definitely see that. Whoa. Whoa. Ooh. Let me go over there, but let's check this out. Interesting. See where this goes real quick. It looks like it goes back to where we were. But I want to see that bridge. It's a good thing I didn't bring the scooter for this. I was almost gonna, but when I looked at the pictures, I saw sand and I was like, no, I gotta bring the bike. I try to avoid bringing the bike because it's very difficult to pick this up and put it in the car because it's so heavy. But there's still some spots where I need the bike. So, wow. I feel like the battery doesn't last as long on this Hero 11 than the Hero 9. And I'm not happy about that. Last I checked, I was already at 58%. It's probably because I was using $5,000 for a little bit, but I don't know. When I left, the battery was at 90%, even though I just charged it fully the other day. So that's concerning to me. I don't know. There's always something. So there's gotta be a problem with something. But this camera does have better dynamic range, so maybe it'll be a better picture than the Hero 9. Especially in these types of situations in the woods where it's high dynamic range, you really need that better dynamic range out of the camera. See, the Insta360 can do HDR video. And that really helps. The Hero 11 GoPro doesn't do that. But it is a little better in dynamic situations. But it would be nice if this had HDR video. This is so weird. Go slow on this turn because my knee. I didn't want to fall on that. So odd. This definitely had to be like a farm or something. I want to get a picture though. So I just checked the battery. It's at 32%. I'm not happy. That's very bad battery life. My Hero 9 gets really good battery life. I can use it all day. I almost never go. Well, by the time I'm done filming, it's usually around 30%. But I'm already at 30%. And I'm not even done with the video. Like, what is going on here? I'm not happy about that. And I'm using all the same settings that I would use on the Hero 9. I'm not happy. There's always got to be something. It's unbelievable. That's nasty. Ooh, that would have been bad. Oh, we were here. Oh. So that's where it led to. So we're back at the village. Whoa, this is where we started. Now there's another spot down over here. So this other trail, it's fairly short. It's right over here. Somewhere. Trying not to fall. This is here. The road along here. I love the fact that I could just blast full speed through these trails and not really have to worry about anything because they're so wide and there's no one around. Although it is a little sketchy. Oh, it's just about the tree. I don't care about the tree. It's a little that's horse. It's sketchy because when you're in the deep sand, I don't want to fall or anything. Supposedly this is going to come up to another lake or whatever. Wow. Alcoholic beverages prohibited. Oh wow, look, we got stairs here. Wow. That's interesting. This controls the water flow. Cool. All right, well, that's it for this video. Double Trouble State Park. Testing the Hero 11 out also, and I'm happy, but I'm also not happy about the battery life. I don't know what's going on. Well, anyway, a cool little park, very weird, but cool, because I just blast around. Very weird, though. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Don't forget to share, like, subscribe, click the bell, and all that stuff. See you later. So we're at the very beginning of the Pine Barrens, or Pine Lands. And, this is the Wharton State Forest that I wanted to visit. See, there's plenty of places to go, but the trails are just like this, and you need a 4x4 vehicle. I could use my Jeep, but I really don't want to because it's got a lot of miles on it. I don't need to break down in the middle of Wharton State Forest. But I do want to go visit Batsell one day. That's an abandoned village, kind of like this one. That'll be another video sometime. You know what? I think I'm just gonna skip on. We got another day. This way, I'm not racing against the sun. We could spend as much time as we want down there. I'll just go another day, even though it sucks to have to come all the way down here again just to go to one spot. But I'll do it another day. That's it for this video.